नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहिए। आई एम डॉक्टर अंचित फ्रॉम द फैकल्टी ऑफ फिजियोथेरेपी एंड डायग्नोस्टिक्स फ्रॉम ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेंस यूनिवर्सिटी। वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग आवर सीरीज ऑन न्यूरोलॉजिकल डिजीजेज एंड इट्स रिहैबिलिटेशन। द टॉपिक दैट वी आर गोइंग टू पिक टुडे इज कॉल्ड अमाइलोट्रोपिक लेटरल स्क्लेरोसिस, ऑल्सो नोन एज ALS इन शॉर्ट फॉर्म, ऑल्सो नोन एज लोउ गेहरिग्स डिजीज। So amyotrophic lateral sclerosis. All right. So we have already learned about multiple sclerosis. So we have known from that fact that sclerosis is basically scarring in the nervous system. So amyotrophic lateral sclerosis is also a degenerative disease of nervous system. It's a deadly disease and it's a progressive disease. It is also considered to be in a group of diseases called motor neuron diseases, because basically it affects the motor neuron of our nervous system. So what happens in ALS? So as I've told you, it's a degenerative disease. So the nervous system starts degenerating, that is the motor neurons that are present, they start getting affected and are degenerated, especially the anterior horn cells of the spinal cord and the motor cortex. So what happens, the medulla oblongata, which is in the brainstem of the brain, so there the tracts which are going from there to the spinal cord, they majorly get affected, and especially the anterior one, because of which all the transmission from the brain is stopped, which causes much of motor signs to appear, such as weakness, such as paralysis. So it's basically a motor neuron disease. So what happens in it is, as the degeneration happens, and degeneration, it being a, why is it called a deadly disease? Because it affects both the upper horn, upper motor neuron, and the lower motor neuron. So it, the combination is really bad for the patient. The symptoms which comes out usually starts from general weakness, which later goes up to, since because it also affects the medulla oblongata, which is responsible for controlling the basic functions of a body, such as breathing, because it controls the diaphragm, speaking, swallowing. So these are the very important functions, and when these get affected along with the motor dysfunction which is being present, the prognosis of the patient isn't that good, and it finally leads up to the death of the patient because of respiratory dysfunctions, majorly because of respiratory dysfunctions, and also the motor part creating the paralysis in the later parts. So it's a progressive disease and it's a deadly disease, and sadly there hasn't been any cure found for the ALS currently. All the treatment available are the symptomatic treatment. So this is a gist about what is ALS. Now, what are the clinical symptoms that are present? Clinical symptoms presented with the patient having ALS, usually he will show generalized weakness. It can either be in the ankles, knees, hands. So the thing with the disease is that it's not specific. It can affect any part. So it can either be single limb that is affected, either it can be both limb affected, either whole body is affected. So whatever part is affected because of the motor neuron being destroyed, there is a development of weakness along with atrophy. So because of the weakness, there atrophy occurs, and that atrophy leads to further weakness of the whole body. So weakness is present, atrophy is present, there may be difficulty in breathing, there may be difficulty in swallowing, excess saliva production will be there, which will be drooling out of the mouth, because the patient will not be able to swallow the saliva. It also controls the speaking, so hoarseness of voice is also present. Later in the stages, when it becomes more progressive, it also affects the higher mental functions. That is, the cognition is also affected. There are attention deficits present in the patient. There may be dementia which will be present in the later stages. There will be mental anxieties. There will be mental depression present in the patient. The depression may also result because of the inability to perform functions. So activities of daily living will start getting affected. As easy as getting up from the bed, getting up from the chair will be affected, because patient will feel weakness and he will not be able to get up and to perform activities of daily living. So this also adds to the mental stress of the patient. The patient gets into depression. Slowly all the activities starts to cease, which is a very severe form of the disease. So patient will present with all this, and how do we diagnose it? There is not a particular test which is present. Basically, with the help of MRIs, we'll see what kind of degeneration is happening, the kind of symptoms he is presenting. We will relate to that. Hallmark will be both the upper motor neurons and the lower motor neurons may get affected, but basically the anterior horn cells are getting affected. So if the symptoms that shows that there is a weakness in the joints present and there is difficulty in swallowing, speaking, so those are the symptoms pointing the fingers toward ALS. Also, nerve conduction velocity tests are done to see the how well the nerves are doing their jobs, how well the transmission is. It also helps us to determine. So it's not a single day diagnosis that can be made. Sometimes the diagnosis can take up to weeks and months to determine that the patient is actually suffering from ALS, because there are several diseases which resembles, because there are, it comes into a group of motor neuron diseases. So there are other motor neuron diseases which also sometimes mimic ALS. So sometimes it takes a lot of time. Now coming on to the treatment part, treatment, as I've said, there is no specific treatment for ALS. So the treatment that we choose is symptomatic treatment. That is, in case the patient is having pain, then we give the patient NSAIDs. In case he is having mental depression, so anti-anxiety and antidepressant pills are given to him. For better nerve conductions, we give him vitamin B12. For general weakness, we ask him to conserve his energy, give him some multivitamins. So basically all the treatment is symptomatic. In case of spasticity, he is giving muscle relaxants. So this is how the treatment follows as per the symptoms being presented by the patient. The treatment, the medication for the same is given. Physical therapy plays a very major role in the disease, because since we know that it's a progressive disease and the patient is only going to deteriorate, so a therapist is needed to make the patient able in whatever condition he is. That means if from starting from the normal phase when he is able to do all his activities, moving towards the phase when he faces difficulties in doing the activities of daily living. So the therapist basically teaches him compensatory techniques, how to compensate, how to overcome the complexities that he is having. For example, if he is having a weakness in one of the ankles which is hampering him to get up, so the therapist teaches the patient how to put all the weight on the second limb and how to make adjustments in getting up, how to become how to come forward and change your center of gravity while getting up. So compensatory techniques are taught depending on the kind of symptoms the patient is showing. So every patient may show different kind of symptoms, because it is, the progression is not described anywhere. It may vary, it actually varies from person to person. So a therapist has to assess every patient accordingly, knowing what difficulty he is getting, and then accordingly he is taught compensatory techniques. Then because he gets fatigued really easily, that he gets really tired very easily, so energy saving techniques are taught to him. Postural changes are taught to him, so that to prevent any kind of contractures being developed or postural pains being developed later. In case of stooping posture, lower back pain initiates after some time, because the patient spends long hours sitting on a chair, so posture has to be really good. So postural correction are done. Light aerobic exercises are prescribed to him or taught to him to do gentle conditioning of the muscles to prevent muscle wasting, to prevent muscle weakness happening. So strengthening is done, stretching is done for the to treat the spasm. Sometimes the patient shows with spasm if the upper motor neuron lesions are there. if the patient is presenting with lower motor neurons, that is, if he is presenting with flaccidity, then techniques are done to increase the muscle tone. So this way a therapist has to mold up with any kind of situation present, teach him compensatory techniques, do conditioning with him, teach him postural changes, do stretching and strengthening exercises, and basically the condition will only deteriorate. So he should be able to taught to be independent as much as possible. In case he is not ambulatory in the later stages, then wheelchair training is given to him so that he can at least be on a wheelchair and do his activities of daily living, that is, go to the loo, do his daily activities, come back to the bed. If he is able to do, he can use the wheelchair to go out, even to go to his work. So a therapist is needed to teach him of whatever function is left to him to make maximum utilization of those functions. So this is about ALS, amyotrophic lateral sclerosis. I hope it's clear to you. In case of any query, do let me know. This session was brought to you by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth, Women's University. Thank you. Have a nice day.